First and foremost, I would like to give all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Kakudash. Yahweh is the name of the Heavenly Father, Yahweh Shai. His name is only begotten Son. Yahweh means He is, He exists. That's the Most High, that's the Heavenly Father. And His Son, Yahweh Shai, His name means He, the Deliverer. He saves. He, the Deliverer, He delivers. And He saves. Yahweh Shai. Okay. And I would like to give double honors to apostles and elders of great millstone rule well, who I'm constantly learning this truth from. And this is for you so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, and you speckled birds scattered across the four corners of the globe, which may look like the other nations, but if this word resonates with you, you are the Hebrew Israelite which the Bible speaks of. And I would like to start off with Book of Zechariah. Zechariah 8 and 1. And it reads again, the word of the Lord Yahweh, His Heavenly Father, of hosts, came to me saying, thus saith the Lord Yahweh, of hosts, I was jealous for Zion, with great jealousy. I was jealous for her with great fury. And notice he, Most High Yahweh, He likens us into a woman. You know, but let's get what Zion means first, so we can try to get a better understanding. Zion.
Strong's H 6726. Zion. Zion.
And that's it, Zion. Let's see. Parts plays another name for Jerusalem, especially in the prophetic books. Okay, let's see. Zion. Zion. Permanent capital, mountain, okay, and I'm pretty sure it means monument too, so let me see if I can find that, signpost, monument, you know, and that goes back to us not knowing who we were. You know, it's like when you go to a funeral, somebody threw up when they buried you, they put up a tombstone, you know, and they, you had know who they are, you know, because it's engraved on that tombstone. Well, our hair has just been taken away from us by the Edomites, you know, which is so-called white man, and the other nations, you know. So now, we're gonna go to let's see, third verse. Thus said the Lord Yahweh, I am returning to Zion and will dwell in the midst of Jerusalem. And Jerusalem shall be called the city of truth. And the mountain of the Lord Yahweh of hosts, the holy mountain. Okay. Now we're gonna go down to Book of Joel. Let's see, Joel, second chapter, and go to the 17th verse. And it reads, Joel 2:17, let the priests, the ministers of the Lord Yahweh, weep between the porch and the altar, and let them say, spare thy people, O Lord Yahweh. And I you put your Hawa shot in there, it's only begotten son, because the only way you're going to get to the Father is through the Son. You know, so when I say Yahweh, which is the Most High, when I say Yahweh, and it means the Most High, Yahweh, it means He is. He exists. You know? And Bahashem in the name, Yahweh, which is His only Son, begotten Son, that means He delivered. Savior. Alright? Let the priests, the ministers of the Lord Yahweh, Bahashem Yahweh Shai, weep between the porch and the altar. And let them say, spare thy people, O Lord Yahweh, and give not thine heritage to reproach, that the heathen should rule over them. Wherefore should they say among the people, where is their power? And that's what they're, you know, saying now, but the people waking up to the fact that, you know, they're waking up to the fact that in light of everything that's going on, they're seeing that these people, the so-called white men, also known as Esau, Edom, also known as the Amalekites, their true name are not the Italians, they are not the Irish, they are not British, they are not this and all these other nations they call themselves. They had a habit of calling themselves, they came from Japheth, this, that, and the third, but their true biblical names are the Edomites, you know. Amalekites, they're all the same. They're not Germans. Everybody been in the trick bag until the truth came out. You know, years, not just, it didn't come out with these basketball players, these stars, came out with the Apostles' Great Millstone, you know. The elders and apostles, the prophets, and it goes back years. I just stepped on not too long ago, but I know that this truth goes all the way back. The Abba Billings, King Mashab, Ariat, and they taught the apostles who's teaching us now. Apostle Tahar, Gabbar, Rakai, and all the other apostles and the bishops, and all of them are our teachers. All of them. And that's why we say we get double honors in apostles and elders of great millstone. They are spiritual fathers. Okay. Whether you're young or old. Because if it weren't for this truth coming out way back then and them doing the work, we wouldn't know, because, you know, that oracles of the Heavenly Father, Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai. Okay? Now, with that, Joel 2:17, let the priests, the ministers of Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, weep between the porch and the altar, and let them say, spare thy people, O Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, and give not thy heritage to reproach, that the heathen should rule over them. Wherefore should they say among the people, where is their power? Okay? And they've been saying that now, like they're getting ready to come at us, you know, made by all the believers, you know, but you know, all these people, all these our people that's stuck on them, they can't shake loose, they're going to be judged. They're going to be judged by Yahweh through them, you know, and him. When that time comes, they're getting judged every day through Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai. When you got all this on the news every day about all these deletions going on. Okay. You know, let's go to Psalms 60, Book of Psalms. And we're going to go to verse chapter 60. Start at 2, It's Psalm 16:2. Thou hast made the earth to tremble. Thou hast broken it. Hear the breaches thereof where it's sacred. Okay. Read that again. Thou hast made the earth tremble. Thou hast broken it. Hear the breaches thereof where it's sacred. And you know, that's for going off, you know, we have gotten punished for it, you know. You know what, let me go on back to Joel Shalaki. Left out something. I'm going back to Joel. What is that? Joel 2:17. And it reads, let the priests, the ministers of the Lord Yahweh, by some Yahweh, weep between the porch and the altar, and let them say, spare thy people, O Lord Yahweh. Again, not thy heritage to reproach. Thy heritage is the elect. You know, that's the Lord's heritage. It's the elect. You know, it's all of Israel, but it's just, in these days, it's the elect of Israel. Which is 144,000. 12,000 out of each tribe, and it's the 12 tribes, you know, you got the northern kingdom and the southern kingdom, you know, all right, that the heathen should rule over them, wherefore would they say among the people, where is their power, all right, now we're going on to Joel 3. Joel 3, 1 through 5, let's read it. Joel 3, verse 1. For behold, in those days and that time, then I shall bring again the captivity of Judah and Jerusalem. You know, I've also gathered all nations and will bring them down to the valley of Jehoshaphat, which is Jehoshaphat. Valley of Decision. Okay, let's pull that up. Beginning at the in the first in the NLT, I will gather the armies of the world into the valley of Jehoshaphat. There I will judge them for harming my people, my special possessions, for scattering my people among the nations, and for dividing up my land. And that's what's happening. And that's what happened. They, you know, they took us, they divided us up, you know, and then they call themselves Ish, you know. They call themselves us. They just did a number on us, okay? That's what they done, all right? And all of that because we went off and Yahweh Vashem and Yahweh Sai punished us for it. You know, they were, you know, part of the curses. And whereas they didn't go through any curses, but yet they call themselves us, you know. Verse 3, they have cast lots for my people, have given a boy for a harlot and sold a girl for wine that they might drink. You know, slavery. You know, so they have a lot to answer for. Verse 3, they have, it's verse 4. Yeah, what have you to do with me, O Tyre, O and Zidon, and all the coast of Philistine, Palestine? Will you render me a recompense? And if you recompense me swiftly and speedily, will I return your recompense upon your head? You got to pay for it. Plain and simple. You got to pay for it. No doubt. Verse 5. Because you have taken my silver and my gold and have carried unto your temples my goodly pleasant things. No. And so you... doing what you did to us. I mean, you got to pay for that. But you never thought you never thought that day was coming. Well, it's here. All right? You were set up to be judged, period. You know? We'll go to Zechariah 8. Verse 3, thus said the Lord Yahweh by his name, House I have returned to Zion, and will dwell in the midst of Jerusalem. Jerusalem shall be called a city of truth. And the mountain of the Lord Yahweh by his name, House I of hosts, the holy mountain. Okay. And that's coming. On its way. Management is about to get transferred to ownership. Yahweh size ownership. Okay. We're gonna go to Exodus 20. Where am I at? Okay. A lot. Okay. Go back in Zechariah 8:2. It said, thus said the Lord, Yahweh by the house of hosts, I was jealous for Zion with great jealousy, and I was jealous for her with great fury. Verse 3. That's said the Lord Yahweh, by Shem Yahweh, I am returning to Zion and will dwell in the midst of Jerusalem. Now, how did he return to Zion? He returned to Zion through the Holy Spirit. You know? And the Holy Spirit is now dwelling in us to do this work and to come back and to give us the wisdom and knowledge and understanding, you know, what's happening and of ourselves. And Yahweh by us in Yahweh side. Bring us back into remembrance. Okay. And the Holy Spirit teaching us how to walk amongst the heathen, how to walk in this wicked society, you know, how to move in it. You know. Also building up other spiritual temple, you know, your spiritual temple. And our government being set up, basically. You know. It's being set up. And they see this. And that's what they're trying to stop. Okay. Revelation 21. Revelation 21 and 2. It started at 1, and I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from Yahweh by Shemi House out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a great voice, verse 3, and I heard a great voice out of heaven said, behold, the tabernacle of the Heavenly Father, Yahweh by Hashem, Yahweh size with men. He will dwell with them, and they shall be his people. And the Heavenly Father, Yahweh himself, shall be with them and be their power. And Yahweh by Hashem, Yahweh size shall wipe away all tears from their eyes. There shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. And he that sat upon the throne said, behold, I will make all things new. And he said unto me, write. For these words are true and faithful. Okay? Now the temple is getting set up now. You know, because it's coming. Our kingdom is coming. Go to Zechariah again. Zechariah 8 and 3, thus saith the Lord Yahweh, I am returning to Zion, and will dwell in the midst of Jerusalem. Jerusalem shall be called the city of truth, and a mountain of the Lord Yahweh, Rashmi House, our host, the holy mountain. Okay? Fourth verse, thus saith the Lord Yahweh, Rashmi House, our host, there shall yet all men and all women dwell in the streets of Jerusalem, and every man with his staff in his hand for every age. And we're going to be living full lives, you know. No more dying at 60, 70, 80, you know. We're going to be living full lives, long lives, forever, you know. And this just, let's go to Psalms 144. Start at 11. Rid me and deliver me from the hand of strange children, whose mouth speaketh vanity, and their right hand is right hand of falsehood. That's those heathen nations, and also Esau, Edom. This is what we're going through now. You know, we want this place to end so we can move. So under Yahweh's side, you know, King David. 144,000, one third men, women, and children of believers. All right. 12 verse. That our sons may be as plants grow up in their youth, that our daughters may be as cornerstones polished after the similitude of a palace, that our garners may be full, affording all manner of store, that our sheep may bring forth thousands and ten thousands in our streets, that our oxen may be strong to labor, that there be no breaking in nor going out, that there be no complaining in our streets. Happy is that people that is in such a case, yeah, happy is that people whose power is the Lord Yahweh, Bahashim Yahweh Shah. And you can't get no happier than that. No more slaving, no more. You know, they're going to be under us, all the other nations. And then after Esau, Edom's task is done, they're going to be destroyed off of our planet, off of our system, our government. They're going to be destroyed, period. No. Okay. Back in Zechariah. Thus said the Lord, six verses, Zechariah 8:6. Thus said the Lord Yahweh Bashmi and Havashai of hosts, if it be marvelous in the eyes of the remnant of this people, and these days should it also be marvelous in mine eyes, said the Lord of hosts. Yeah. Because the Lord of hosts, Yahweh, Bahashim Yahweh Shai, he made us for him. We are his heritage. You know. We are his prize. We are his bride. You know, that's why We have to be humble. Remember where we come from. We came from sin, you know. Granted that we're repenting every day, but we still have to be humble. And hope. You know, you are hopeful elect. Speak to me, myself foremost. You're hopeful elect, you know. Or we can say we the elect because we can't do the two, but we hope to be saved up out of here, you know. One on chairs when this time, when that time comes, when this past year approaches, but we have to keep doing the work, the best way, the best we can, and the best, you know, and whatever we know, whatever we got, whatever we've been taught, you know. And through faith, you know. Yeah, I hope to get out of here, you know. That's my hope. Okay. It's like it's up in my eye. Okay, where I'm at. Okay, Psalms 119. That would be Psalms 119:71. It is good for me that I have been afflicted, that I might learn thy statutes. Yeah, because you look that up in the NLT. Psalms 119:71 in the NLT it reads, my sufferings was good for me, for it taught me to pay attention to your decrees. Exactly. You know, the sufferings that we went through and that we're going through is teaching you to pay attention to what's going on, you know, and pay attention to the law, Yahweh Basha and Yahweh Shah, you know. And what you're supposed to be doing. You don't want to stop doing it. Because he's showing us this grace. You know. And that's mercy. That he's showing us. Giving us this life. Through the elder apostle, the great millstone. On down. Through the teachers, you know. Through the prophets, through the bishops. Because they speak Yahweh fires in Yahweh's house to have two or more gathered in the name of Yahweh fires in Yahweh's house. He is in the midst. Okay. Zechariah 8:7. That said, the Lord Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shah host, behold, I will save my people from the east country and from the west country. And I will bring them, and they shall dwell in the midst of Jerusalem. They shall be my people, and I will be their power in truth and in righteousness. Okay. Revelation 2:21. Let's go to Revelation 21. And it reads, and I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, behold, the tabernacle of Heavenly Father Yahweh, by Shem Yahweh, sides with men. And he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people. And Heavenly Father Yahweh, by Shem Yahweh, sides himself, shall be with them and be their power. Okay? And that tabernacle is with men, the third temple, the new covenant. You know, that's the new covenant in which these Amalekites, they call themselves Ishes. Ain't no such thing, they're not in the new covenant. You see what's going on over there and in this world right now. You know, so he said, you're a liar. Right? Jeremiah 3:17. Just start at 15. and I will give you passes according to my heart, which shall feed you with knowledge and understanding. And it shall come to pass when ye be multiplied and increased in the land of those days, said the Lord Yahweh. By Hashem Yahweh, so they shall say no more the ark of the covenant of the Lord Yahweh, by Hashem Yahweh, so neither shall it come to mind, neither shall they remember it, neither shall they visit it, neither shall that be done any more. 17 verse. At that time they shall call Jerusalem the throne of the Lord Yahweh, by Hashem Yahweh, and all the nations shall be gathered unto it, to the name of the Lord Yahweh, by Hashem Yahweh, to Jerusalem. Neither shall they walk any more after the machinations of their evil heart. Okay? So the 18th verse, in those days the house of Judah shall walk with the house of Israel. They shall come together out of the land of the north to the land that I have given for inheritance unto your fathers. Okay? And we will be that temple. Laws, statutes, and commandments will be in us. The stony hearts will be replaced with fleshly hearts. And we gonna be judging them, you know. They got to follow our power. They got to follow the laws that is set up already for you know, in our kingdom, you know, Yahweh's kingdom. You know, there'll be no more Christmas, Halloween, none of that. They attempt to try that, they're done, you know. There'll be no more eating rats and bats, none of that. You know, Zechariah 8:9, and it reads, "Thus said the Lord Yahweh, Hashem Yahweh, our host, let your hands be strong, ye that hear in these days these words by the mouth of the prophets, which were the day that the foundation of the house of the Lord Yahweh, Hashem Yahweh, our host, was laid, that the temple might be built." Okay. Now, we're going to go to Book of Sirach. Which is the Apocrypha. And we say Sirach because in the Apocrypha, it's called Ecclesiasticus. And some people get confused. You know. So we, in another word for it is Sirach. Some people say Sirach, but Sirach, okay, 36:11, chapter 36, Ecclesiasticus 36, 11 verse. And it reads, this is Sirach, 11 verse, 36, chapter 11 verse, and it reads, "Gather all the tribes of Jacob together, and inherit thou them as from the beginning. O Lord, have mercy upon the people that is called by thy name, and upon Israel, whom thou hast named thy firstborn. O be merciful unto Jerusalem, thy holy city, the place of thy works. Rest, so like you rest. Fill Zion with thine unspeakable oracles, and thy people with thy glory. Give testimony to those that thou hast possessed from the beginning, and raised up, and raise up prophets that have been in thy name. Reward them that wait for thee, and let thy prophets be found faithful. O Lord Yahweh, Hashem Yahweh Shai, hear the prayer of thy servants, according to the blessings of Aaron over the people, over thy people, that all they which dwell upon the earth may know that thou art the Lord Yahweh, Hashem Yahweh Shai, the eternal power." Okay. I'm going to go to Jeremiah, Book of Jeremiah. Okay. That would be Book of Jeremiah 29, chapter. Here we go to the 11th verse. and there is, for I know the thoughts that I think toward you, saith the Lord Yahweh, Bahashim Yahweh Shai, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end. Then you should call upon me, and you shall go and pray unto me, and I will hearken unto you. And you shall seek me and find me, when you shall search for me with all your heart. Okay? 14th verse. And I will be found of you, saith the Lord Yahweh, Bahashim Yahweh Shai, and I will turn away your captivity, and I will gather you from all the nations and from all the places whither I have driven you, saith the Lord Yahweh, Bahashim Yahweh Shai, and I will bring you again into the place whence I caused you to be carried away captive. Because you have said, 15th verse, because you have said, the Lord Yahweh, Bahashim Yahweh Shai, hath raised us up prophets in Babylon. Verse. Know that thus said the Lord Yahweh, Bahashim Yahweh Shai, the king that sitteth upon the throne of David, and of all the people that dwell in this city, and of your brethren that are not gone forth with you into captivity. Thus said the Lord Yahweh, Bahashim Yahweh Shai, host, behold, I will send upon them the sword, the famine, and the pestilence, and will make them like vile figs that cannot be eaten. They are so evil. And I will persecute them with the sword, with the famine, and with the pestilence, and will deliver them to be removed to all the kingdoms of the earth, to be a curse and astonishment and a hissing and a reproach among all the nations where I have driven them. That was our judgment, our punishment. No. That was our punishment. You know, but I suppose I stopped at the 15th verse. You know, so let me read that again. Jeremiah 29:11. Selaki. Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the thoughts that I think toward you, said the Lord Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shai, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end. 12th verse. Then shall you call upon me, and you shall go and pray unto me, and I will hearken unto you. All right. 13th verse. And you shall seek me and find me, when you shall search for me with all your heart. All right. You gotta keep studying, searching, doing what you're supposed to do, what you need to do. All right. 14th verse. And I will be found that you said, the Lord, Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shai, and I will turn away your captivity, and I will gather you from all the nations and from all the places where I had driven you, said the Lord Yahweh, Bahashim Yahweh Shai, and I will bring you again into a place where I caused you to be carried away captive. No. All right, this last verse, 15. Because you have said the Lord Yahweh, Bahashim Yahweh Shai, have raised us up prophets in Babylon, okay? And that's what he did. That's what he did, and he's still doing it because the elect is not sealed yet. You'll know it, but it's coming to that point. No. Speaking as a man, but we're coming to that point because it's getting ready to be famine in the world soon. You know, so you got to get this water, get this living water. Let's go to Isaiah. That'll be Isaiah 35. It's going to start at the 7th verse, Isaiah 35 and 7. And the parched ground shall become a pool, and the thirsty land springs of water, and the habitation of dragons, where each day shall be grass with reeds and rushes. You know? And the parched ground shall become a pool, and the thirsty land springs of water. You know, so that, you know, waking up out of that sleep, you know, getting all that knowledge, wisdom, and understanding, you know, and the habitation of evil, of the dragons, Esau, Edom, Babylon, you know, land of darkness, okay. Eight verse. And a highway shall be there, and a way, and it shall be called the way of holiness. The unclean shall not pass over, but it shall be for those, the wayfaring men, though fools shall not err therein. You know, so that's the highways and byways. That's calling for the elect, you know, because, the, you know, people not going to come to the light, you know, because they want to, you know, keep, they want to stay in the darkness. They want to keep doing that wickedness, you know. So that's what this is for, the elect, all right? Go to Zechariah 8, 9th verse. That said, the Lord Yahweh by some Yahweh's house, let your hands be strong. Ye that hear in these days, these words by the mouth of the prophets, which were in the day that the foundation of the house of the Lord Yahweh by some Yahweh's house was laid, that the temple might be built. Yep. The temple of Yahweh by some Yahweh's house, you know. Temple of David, you know. House of David. You know. Now, to the Amos, book of Amos, start at 10. All the sinners of my people shall die by the sword, which say that evil shall not overtake nor prevent us. Okay, verse 11. In that day will I rise at the tabernacle of David that is fallen, and close to the breaches thereof, and I will raise up his ruins, and I will build it as in the days of old, that they may possess the remnant of Edom and of all the heathen, which I call by my name, said the Lord Yahweh by Hashem Yahweh, that doeth this. Behold, the days come, said the Lord Yahweh by Hashem Yahweh, that the plowman shall overtake the reaper, and the treader of the grapes. Him that sows seed in the mountain shall drop sweet wine, and all the hills shall melt. You know, so you'll do this like this. You'll go to the NLT. Same verse, but in the NLT, the time will come, said the Lord Yahweh by Hashem Yahweh, when the grain and the grapes grow faster, then they can be harvested. Then the tares, vineyards on the hills of Israel will drip with sweet wine. Well, harvesting. It's almost harvest time. Okay. Isaiah 58 and 12. And getting this wisdom, you know, knowledge, understanding. We can start at 11. I said 58:11. And the Lord Yahweh by Hashem Yahweh shall guide thee continually, and satisfy thy soul and drop, and make fat thy bones. And thou shalt be like a water garden, and like a spring of water, whose waters fail not. You know, that's the truth and the wisdom that you're getting with the understanding. Verse 12. And they that shall be of thee shall build the old waste places. Thou shalt rise up the foundations of many generations, and thou shalt be called the repairer of the breach, the restorer of paths to dwell in. You know, so you're going to be taught this word, and you're going to understand it. You're going to learn it, understand it, and you're going to walk in the ways of old. You're going to walk in the ways of our customs, you know. You're gonna give up. You know, basically, you're gonna give up these ways of this wicked queendom. You know, you're gonna want to find a true way, which is our way, which we was hidden from us from all these years. You know, so from that. Zechariah again, and we're gonna go to Zechariah 6th chapter, 15 verse. And it reads, Zechariah 6:15, and they that are far off shall come and build in the temple of the Lord Yahweh, Ba'asim Yahawasah, and ye shall know that the Lord Yahweh, Ba'asim Yahawasah, our host, have sent me unto you, and this shall come to pass, if you will diligently obey the voice of the Lord Yahweh, Ba'asim Yahawasah, your power. You know, so you got to, you know, you got to continue to obey. You know, and with fear you will obey. I know this. You will obey, no doubt. And it, you know, it's all about that faith and hope. You know, I got the faith now. I hope, you know, to get off this rock, you know, be beamed up in the chariot when the demise of this place, the destruction of these wicked, the wicked, you know, I'm going to be off this place, you know, and watch it from the chariot, looking through the ozone layer, you know. I pray that, a few more prophecies left, you know, you get the Karagma, you know, you be already at World War III, you know. Bank is getting ready to totally collapse. Or Abkhaz, you know, take his trouble. You know, winter is coming. It's going to be a dark winter, you know, most definitely. You know, but let me continue. Let's go to Zechariah 8:10. Start at 9. Thus said the Lord Yahweh, Ba'asim Yahawasah, our host, let your hands be strong, ye that hear these days, these words by the mouth of the prophets, which were in the day that the foundation of the house of the Lord Yahweh host was laid, that the temple might be built. Verse 10. But before these days, there was no hire for men, nor any hire for beasts. Neither was there any peace to him that went out or came in because of the affliction. For I set all men, every one against his neighbor. But now I will not be unto the residue of this people as in the former days, said the Lord Yahweh of hosts. For the seed shall be prosperous, the vine shall give her fruit, and the ground shall give her increase, and the heavens shall give her dew, and I will cause a remnant of this people to possess all these things. That's the remnant, you know. That's the elect of the elect of Israel. You know. Verse 13, and it shall come to pass that as ye were a curse among the heathen, O house of Judah, O house of Israel, so will I save you, and ye shall be a blessing. Fear not, but let your hands be strong. But thus said the Lord Yahweh, Ba'asim Yahawasah of hosts, as I thought to punish you when your fathers provoked me to wrath, said the Lord Yahweh, Ba'asim Yahawasah of hosts, and I repented not. So again have I thought in those days to do well unto Jerusalem and to the house of Judah. Fear ye not. Verse 16. Those are the things that ye shall do. Speak ye, every man the truth to his neighbor, execute the judgment of truth and peace in your gates, and let none of you imagine evil in your house against his neighbor, and love no false oath, for all these are things I hate, said the Lord Yahweh, Ba'asim Yahawasah. You know, so that, those are precepts and commands, you know. They got to be done. I speak to myself first and foremost. They have to be done. Okay. 1 Corinthians. First Corinthians. We're going to start at 8. First Corinthians 3 and 8. Now he that planet, and he that watereth, I won. And every man shall receive his own reward according to his own labor. Verse 9. For we are laborers together with the Heavenly Father Yahweh. Blasphemy Yahweh Shai. We are Yahweh's husbandry. Ye are Yahweh Blasphemy Yahweh Shai building. According to the grace of the Heavenly Father Yahweh Blasphemy Yahweh Shai, which is given unto me as a wise master builder, I have laid the foundation and another buildeth thereof. But let every man take heed how he buildeth thereupon. For other foundations can no man lay than that is laid, which is Yahweh Shai HaMashiach. Now, if any man build upon this foundation gold, silver, precious stones, wood, hay, stubble, verse 13, every man's work shall be made manifest, for the day shall declare, because it shall be revealed by fire, and the fire shall try every man's work of what sort it is. Verse 14, if any man's work abide, which he hath built thereupon, he shall receive a reward. Verse 15, if any man's work shall be burned, he shall suffer loss, but he himself shall be saved, yet so as by fire. Okay. So we have to do the work and study and keep pushing, because we are in the last of the last days. You know, and that time is quickly coming upon us. No. It's quickly coming upon us. And you want to be ready. Speaking to me first and foremost. You know. Because I tell you this, we could be our own worst enemy. You know, I'm proof positive of that. You know, as far as my life experiences, you know. But this right here, you want to do whatever you can do, for what you know, what you receive from the prophets, from Yahweh Basim, Yahweh Shai, from the teachers. You want to do what you have to do, and do it in prayer, do it in hope, do it in don't waste your grace, and pray on it. And keep that old man away. Keep that old man away and constantly fight the good fight. And keep pushing. And with that, again, let's give all praise, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Basham, Yahweh Shai, Basham, Kakudas. Again, double honors, apostles, elders, a great real millstone who will, and who I'm constantly learning this truth from. The right to be Yahweh Basim, Yahweh Shai, Basim, Kakudas, call Lil Mla, Yahweh Basim, Yahweh Shai. And with that, Shalom.